What's good, fight fans? Can we talk about Anthony Joshua and his complete meltdown? Let's talk about Leon Edwards as he shocks the world, you know what I'm saying, by knocking out Kamaru Usman. Join us next.
You're listening to the Gloves Off podcast. Powered by IE Sports Radio, the show that brings you raw boxing debate with your host, Marcus Los Great.
What's good, fight fans? It's your boy, Marcus. Close, great, here to give you what you want, here to give you what you need, yeah man, yeah. Welcome, welcome, welcome back to the Gloves Off podcast, your first, your last, your everything and all that is combat sports. We are coming to you live. Straight from your mama's basement in a crispy, your boy said crispy, white tee. We are powered by IE Sports Radio, your direct feed for all that is sports. Now you know. So before we get started, just in case them feds is listening, all thoughts and opinions of the Gloves Off podcast are the thoughts and opinions of Mr. Marcus Los Great. In no way, shape, or form represent the thoughts and opinions of IE Sports Radio. Welcome to Season 3, Episode 27. Shout out to the chat room. To my brother, Mr. Taryn Rodriguez, the hardest working man here at IE Sports Radio. Yeah, we can't be having them fans bust me, man. You know what I'm saying? We don't want to be on the run. You know what I'm saying? So this weekend we got Anthony Joshua versus Oleander Usyk, part two. It was a great fight. Unfortunately, Anthony Joshua came up short. He lost the fight via split decision. And then the meltdown occurred. My man was throwing belts out the ring. My man was, you know, singing on the mic. My man was doing too much. You know what I'm saying? He was doing way too much. You know what I'm saying? But, I mean, it's understandable. My man put all his eggs in the basket. He expected to be victorious. And when he came up short, he didn't know what to do. So he flipped out. He went crazy. You know what I'm saying? He went insane. You know what I'm saying? Let's see what Twitter's got to say about this. You know what I'm saying? Let's see what y'all talking about in these Twitter streets. Just made me like Usyk even more. What a humble, genuine, nice man he is. Really professional, always great sportsman from him. I like AJ, but he's always seemed a little fake. He overthinks and tries to present himself a certain way. His biggest opponent is himself. He needs to get over his fear of being hit, fear of losing, his doubt in himself. He would never admit it, but it's obvious that he doubts himself all the time. He should have won that fight on paper due to his size and power. But he was doubting himself again and scared to let his hands go. Wow. So you believe that Anthony Joshua was afraid to let his hands go? In this second fight, Anthony Joshua let his hands go even more. The first fight, maybe you have an argument. You know what I'm saying? The first fight, you got no argument from me. First fight, he held his hands. He was basically trying to outbox the boxer. It didn't work out in his favor. This fight, he tried to use his strength. He tried to bully Usyk. He tried to, you know, use his power. Unfortunately, skills pay the bills. Let me repeat that for you. Skills pay the bills. You know what I'm saying? And Usyk has skills. You know what I'm saying? Not only does Usyk have skills, he has enough power to keep these heavyweights off of him. And that's the scary thing. Because this man can move like a cruiserweight. He can box inside and out. And he has enough power, enough pop, to keep the heavyweights honest. Usyk is a problem for the heavyweight division. Now, I know you guys are thinking to yourselves, oh, man, this is a change of heart for Marcus Lowe's great. You know what I'm saying? When the information changed, my opinion changes. When Usyk first came into the heavyweight division, I didn't believe that he believed that he belonged in a ring with an Anthony Joshua, with a Deontay Wilder, with a Tyson Fury. He has changed my mind. Again, skills pay the bills. You know what I'm saying? Now, as far as AJ being fake, AJ, I wouldn't say that AJ is being fake. I believe that in England, the way you present yourself is a little different than they do here in the States. In the States, the American black fighter is allowed to be loud, is allowed to talk junk, is allowed to do all those things. In England, that's frowned upon. So I believe that Anthony Joshua was just doing what was in his best interest. Now, could you say that that's fake? Well, to a degree. But I mean, at the same time, if that's the way you were raised, you can't say that's fake. That's part of his DNA. You know what I'm saying? His DNA is to act proper. His DNA is to present himself in a certain way. He's not going to go out there like Floyd. You know what I'm saying? And tell dudes straight to their face that he was going to beat them down. And then go in the ring and do it. You know what I'm saying? That's too much bravado. That's what you get from American fighters. That's not something that happens with British fighters. So I think you guys got to take that into account. Let's keep on looking at the comments here. Anthony Joshua acted like a kid. He slightly punched Usyk's team member in the chest. Threw the belts. Took Usyk's flag. This man is truly a kid in this. I agree with you. You know what I'm saying? I didn't agree that I didn't like the fact that he threw the belts out of the ring. I didn't like the fact that, you know, basically created a little bit of a melee inside the ring. We could have went without that. So I agree with you on that. You know what I'm saying? No doubt. No doubt. Next comic. Comment, Usyk's claim calm under the situation is to be saluted. Not only he clearly outboxed Joshua two fights in a row, but he kept his head when your beaten opponent is that disrespectful and shows the kind of man that he is. Now, that being said, Joshua's human, and that happens. Sometimes you lose it. and you lose it. I agree. You know what I'm saying? I felt that Joshua is human. And a lot of these guys, in order for them to feel, basically unbeatable, indestructible, you know, to feel like they're the baddest man on the planet, you know, they have to take themselves to a place where they feel that they can't be beat. You know, you got guys like Floyd Mayweather, Roy Jones Jr. You couldn't tell those guys that they would lose. You know what I'm saying? They couldn't compute it. That's a heavyweight. I mean, that's a champion's DNA. You know what I'm saying? Now, you know, basically, would you say that, you know, he should humble themselves? Maybe. But that ain't humbling is for suckers, man. I've never believed in that humble bullshit. You know who's humble? People that don't get shit done. You know what I'm saying? When I'm in my element, I'm not fucking humble. You know what I'm saying? I'm not humble at all when I'm in my element. Because I know nobody can fucking touch me in my element. You know what I'm saying? And that's the way I carry myself. You know, so I can't be coming down on fighters talking about, man, you should be humble. You know, you should bow down and kiss the brass ring. I don't believe in that. You know what I'm saying? I don't believe in that. But I believe that he should have kept his head in the situation. I believe that he shouldn't have thrown the belts out of the ring. I believe that he shouldn't have created the melee inside the ring. I believe that he shouldn't have got on the mic. I felt that he was way too emotional at that point to even give us something to work with at that point. He wanted to get on the mic. He wanted to give Usyk his props. That's one thing I will basically credit him for. You know, he lost that night, and he still gave Usyk his props, even though he threw the belts out of the ring. You know what I'm saying? So, I mean, you know, there was things he did wrong. There was things that he did right. It just is what it is. You know what I'm saying? It just is what it is. You know what I'm saying? Let's see what else we have here. The crowd started to boo as he was leaving. They didn't like the reaction to the loss. I think he went back into the ring to get the mic to explain himself, his passion, etc. to the crowd. But man, that wasn't the way. He should have waited until after Usyk had his moment first. I mean, that's debatable. I mean, you just let's go out and relive it. He was just out there in the ring showing his ass. You know what I'm saying? He's throwing the belts out of the ring. You know what I'm saying? He's pushing the other team's trainers. You know what I'm saying? You're a professional fighter and you're pushing a trainer. You know what I'm saying? He had to go back out there. He had to go back out there and apologize. Could he waited until after Usyk, you know, got on the mic? Maybe. But I think it was very important for him to address that moment, and I think he did what he thought was right. I can't clown him for that. You know what I'm saying? I can't clown him for that. You know what I'm saying? A perfect example of how to deal with somebody having a tantrum. What a role model, Mr. Usyk. You is a deserved winner. Usyk deserved the win because he did what he needed to do to win the fight. Regardless if Anthony Joshua threw a tantrum afterwards, it really doesn't matter. You know what I'm saying? It really doesn't matter. Absolute disgrace, throwing the belts, ranting off. He showed more aggression and arguing with people than he did in the fight. I disagree with that. I believe that Anthony Joshua was actually trying to put together punches and combinations in this particular fight. You got to give Usyk credit for his defense. Usyk was keeping Anthony Joshua off balance with his jab and his footwork. You know what I'm saying? I don't think that Usyk gets enough credit for his footwork. You know what I'm saying? You guys got to give this man his credit. He not only beat Anthony Joshua once, he beat him twice. Give the man his props. You know what I'm saying? And this is coming from a dude that said he didn't belong in the heavyweight division. He made a believer out of me, and he should have made a believer out of you. You know what I'm saying? He deserves his props. Give the man his flowers. Usyk, great personality, great human being, lots and lots of respect. I agree. Usyk is so composed. Joshua tosses the belts. His reaction, a simple little head nod and grin as if to say fair enough. Yeah, I agree with all those things. Absolutely shameful behavior from AJ. I agree. It was shameful, but I understand. You know what I'm saying? When you're at this level and you believe that you're great, you may do some things that are out of character. You know, never in my lifetime would I imagine that I seen Mike Tyson bite a man's ear in the ring. Never. Never in my lifetime would I imagine someone trying to break, Floyd Mayweather's arm in a boxing ring. Never in my lifetime would I imagine ever seeing somebody bite Floyd Mayweather's hand in a boxing match. You know what I'm saying? In that boxing ring, a lot of emotions are on the surface, and things can pop off, man. They can pop off. The look on Usyk's face after AJ drops the belts out the ring says it all. Complete, absolutely classless. I agree. I would have had the same reaction. Like, what's going on, man? Why are you throwing the belts out the ring? You know what I'm saying? Matter of fact, I would have probably ran up on him. You know what I'm saying? What's going on? I 100% agree with that one. I can't believe he grabbed the mic and actually hip-hop parade a man. Funniest meltdown in boxing history. I think at that point, Anthony Joshua was just trying to redeem himself. You know what I'm saying? He had lost his cool. He was exposed out there. It was ugly. It was ugly. You know what I'm saying? I think he was doing any and everything he could to put the attention back on Usyk where it belonged. And he did what he thought was right to do it. You know what I'm saying? Last comment that we're going to read on this is win, a lose, or draw. This is disgusting. With that being said, with the way Usyk handled the situation, he just became my favorite fighter. Solid man that Usyk is. My favorite fighter in the heavyweight division is Deontay Wilder. I'm sorry. You know what I'm saying? I like Usyk. You know, I'll root for Usyk. I don't think he beats Tyson Fury, but I now think that's a 50-50 fight now. You know what I'm saying? I think it's a 50-50 fight. I can't wait to see it. I think it's going to be the biggest grossing fight in Britain history, and I can't wait for it. You know what I'm saying? Beforehand, if you told me that fight was going to be made, I would clearly said that Tyson Fury wins that fight hands down. But like I said, when you get presented with new information, you got to change your argument, man. Usyk is the complete deal here in the heavyweight division. The kid's got speed. He's got foot speed. He's got, a jab. You know what I'm saying? And he's got pop. You know what I'm saying? He's got all the tools necessary to be the best heavyweight in the world. You know what I'm saying? But right now, in my opinion, that title goes to Tyson Fury because he beat my dude, the baddest man in the world, the baddest man in the land. You know what I'm saying? He beat my dude by knockout in two fights. You know what I'm saying? So, you know, while they go ahead and duke it out, I would like to see Anthony Joshua pull himself up by his bootstraps and win a fight. And then I would like to see him get back into the ring with my boy Deontay Wilder. You know what I'm saying? Because I believe that that is a fight that we all want to see, that we will still watch. Will it be as huge as it would have been like 3 years ago? No. But that fight is still going to be huge in boxing. It's still going to be huge for the heavyweight division, and I can't wait to see it. I can't wait to see it.
Yeah, but you're one of the big groups.
You know what I'm saying? So the next thing that we need to touch on is, you know, basically Lucky Leon Edwards shocked the world. He shocked the world by knocking out Kamaru Usman cold. Cold. Taryn, please tell me you've seen this man knocked out cold staring at the rooftops. Please tell me you've seen it. Man, this man was knocked out cold. Now, mind you, this was a fight that Kamaru Usman was dominating. You know what I'm saying? Kamaru Usman was dominating this fight. He was on to a victory. And at the very last minute, he loses the fight via kick to the jaw. You know what I'm saying? And he's knocked out cold. You know what I'm saying? Some of you guys out here, man, some of you guys, dude, some of you guys out here, man, are killing me, man, because you're acting as if, you know, you're acting as if this was not Lucky. This man was losing this fight. You know what I'm saying? And there is no way, no how, that I see Leon Edwards winning the rematch. But, you know, you got to give Leon Edwards his props. He stayed focused. He continued to fight the fight. Even though he was losing, he was still looking for openings. And he landed his opening. He took advantage of his opportunity. You know what I'm saying? Let's read some of these comments on Twitter. Let's see what's popping out here in these Twitter streets. Congratulations to Leon Edwards on becoming the new UFC welterweight champion. I made this video almost a month before the fight with Kamaru Usman. Before the fight with Kamaru Usman was announced. Glad this story had an awesome ending. It's definitely an awesome ending. I mean, you got this guy who has this Rocky persona. He's losing the fight. He's being dominated by the champion. He's being taken to the ground. He's getting pounded. He's getting taken to the mat. He's being eaten alive by a future Hall of Famer. And then out of nowhere, the last second, he lands a knockout blow, knocking this man out cold. This is what dreams is made of. You know what I'm saying? This is what everybody was talking about. The difference between UFC and boxing. You know what I'm saying? Because anything can happen in a sport. You know what I'm saying? Just when you think you have me, you find out you don't. I had to throw that in there. You know what I'm saying? A little. You know what I'm saying? I had to get a little saucy. You know what I'm saying? I couldn't help myself. You know what I'm saying? This is what I do. All right. What other comments we got out here? Looks like Leon has proved everyone wrong. This loser in life shut down the pound-for-pound king from beating Anderson Silva's record. I don't think that Leon proved anyone wrong. You know what I'm saying? As much as Leon won this fight, you know, via KO, we all know who's going to win the rematch. We do. I mean, if you don't know who's going to win the rematch, you're lying to yourself. You know what I'm saying? We all know who's going to win this rematch. Who's here after the KO of Marty? George, a loser. Kobe, who? Leon, champ. Okay, that was funny. All right. I'll give you. I'll let you live. You know what I'm saying? Can I live? And now Usman is probably going to be out another year. Laugh my ass off, poor Leon. No, I think Kamaru Usman, you guys just lit a fire under this man's ass. This man is coming back for his championship belt. I can't wait for the rematch. The rematch is going to happen soon. I know it. The man probably left his dressing room immediately after getting knocked out. Left his dressing room, went down there to Dana White and said, sign me up for the fight now. You know what I'm saying? Let's see here. You're just a loser in life, man, says Masvidal, while bragging about sucker punching a dude he refuses to fight fairly. Laugh my ass off, the irony. You know what? I believe that Jorge Masvidal is willing to fight anybody. You know what I'm saying? I believe Jorge Masvidal is willing to fight anyone. I don't know about this idea of him sucker punching. I'm going to leave that for you guys to interpretate. You know what I'm saying? I'm going to back off of that. Thanks for hanging in there. Leon Edwards' story. Yeah, I mean, he definitely provided a story for the internet. The internet was buzzing all weekend. You know what I'm saying? We can't be mad. We're going to get a rematch. You know what I'm saying? We're going to get a rematch. Leon will whoop George. I don't know if Leon will whoop George, man. I thought that Leon barely got past Nate. You know what I'm saying? I think that Leon barely got past Nate. Now, yes, he was winning and dominating that fight until he got caught in the fourth or fifth round. You know what I'm saying? But if there was more time on the clock, I think Leon gets stopped. Man, I think he gets stopped. So, I mean, all you guys claiming that he beats Jorge Masvidal? I don't know, man. I don't know. Feels so bad for Leon. Hope he gets the title with all that he's been through. What do you mean you hope he gets the title? He's the new UFC welterweight champion in the world. Of course he's got the title. What do you mean? After all that he's been through, all he gets is a thanks for hanging in there. Jesus, the UFC is brutal.
That's even better.
Is the UFC brutal or is the UFC realistic? I mean, like I said, man, we all seen the fight. We all seen that Leon Edwards was getting thoroughly dominated, man. I mean, let's not act like Leon Edwards was winning this fight and then, you know, put the cherry on top. Let's not do that. You know what I'm saying? Let's not do that. They better respect this man hasn't lost a fight in years. I respect Leon. Leon's got skills. This is the fight that we've all been asking for because basically he gave Kamaru Usman a tough fight the first time around. But in this second fight, he was getting beat down. He was getting taken down to the ground at will. You know what I'm saying? Let's not act like he was going toe-to-toe, blow for blow with this man. You know what I'm saying? That's not the story. Let's move on to the next topic here. You know, basically Adrian Broner. He had to pull out of this fight with Omar Figueroa. He pulled out of the fight due to mental health. You know what I'm saying? He pulled out of the fight on fight week. That was disgusting. It was disgusting. You know what I'm saying? It was completely disgusting that he did that. You know what I'm saying? What has these Twitter streets got to say about it? When Ryan did the same thing, everyone said, I don't think it was a bad idea for him to pull out of the fight. When Broner pulls out, he's right. He definitely shouldn't have jumped in the ring. Unbelievable. Yeah, I mean, we clowned Ryan when he did it. You know what I'm saying? It showed that he was mentally weak. I don't think that Adrian Broner is having mental problems. I think Adrian Broner is fat. You know what I'm saying? And he's not dedicated on his training the way that he's supposed to be. And I think that's the reason why he pulled out of the fight. Allegedly. You know what I'm saying? Allegedly. You know what I'm saying? I think now, in today's climate, it just seems like everybody's throwing mental health around like it's a frisbee. You know what I'm saying? I can't do this because of mental health. I can't do that because of mental health. Oh, I killed my mom because of mental health. Come on, man. Where's personal accountability? You know what I'm saying? That's where I'm cut from. Personal accountability. You know what I'm saying? A man who stands for his actions. You know what I'm saying? If I messed up, my bad. You know what I'm saying? I'm going to try to do better next time. You know what I'm saying? I'm not going to sit up here and give you a fluff line like, man, I was having mental health. No, man. I'm going to tell you, man, I messed up. That's my bad. My fault. We're going to get it right next time. You know what I'm saying? I don't understand where you guys are coming from in this new world today. You know what I'm saying? Everything's mental health. You know what I'm saying? I'm shooting up the mall because of mental health. You know what I'm saying? I'm shooting up schools because of mental health. No, man, you're shooting up schools for no reason. You know what I'm saying? Those people talked about you, and you can handle it. When, you know, at the end of the day, what we used to call that is mentally fragile people. And we have a lot of them in our society. A lot of you guys are mentally fragile. You know what I'm saying? Adrian Broner pulled out of this fight because of personal accountability. He pulled out of this fight because he couldn't hold himself, you know, accountable for his weight. And he was fat. And he was afraid. He was afraid that he was going to lose the comeback fight. Now, did he miss out on an opportunity? Because Omar went into the bout with a guy who only had 7 days to prepare for him. And Omar got knocked out. He got stopped. Did Adrian Broner miss an opportunity to shine? To look good? To put himself back in the bright lights? I believe he missed out on an opportunity. I believe Adrian Broner has to answer some real questions for himself. Is boxing the thing that he loves? Is boxing, you know, only the, you know, is he only in boxing just to get paid? Because if he is, if he's only in boxing just to get paid, he's going to end up getting hurt in that ring. He's going to end up getting hurt. You know what I'm saying? I don't know what he's doing. I don't know what he's doing, but it's got to come to an end. You know what I'm saying? Let's check out a few more comments here before we go. I respect the fact that he didn't take the money and lay down. That alone makes me respect him much more. No, the man, he doesn't get no kudo points for that, man. He don't get no kudo points for that. You know what I'm saying? Adrian Broner is supposed to be a professional. He's supposed to show up on fight day and handle his business. This guy is not only supposed to be a professional, he's supposed to be one of the best in our sport. We got to hold him accountable. We can't keep giving these people passes. We can't do this anymore. I hope Adrian Broner overcomes any medical issues. However, I don't see how he could get into the Hall of Fame. His best win is either Pauly or DeMarco. The fact of the matter is he's going to get into the Hall of Fame because he's won four different belts and four different weight classes. I mean, people may not agree with it, but at the end of the day, that is special. You know what I'm saying? That's special. You know what I'm saying? So he's going to get into the Hall of Fame for that. AB will be talking shit in 2 weeks. I can't remember the last time he won a fight. I'm done hoping that it gets together. He is making us all look bad. He's making himself look bad. He's not making us look bad. I mean, just because you're a fan of a fighter doesn't mean you look bad because the man looks bad. Like I said, Adrian Broner has to hold himself accountable. You know what I'm saying? He has to get himself together. He's got to ask himself some real questions. Are you in this for the sport, or are you in it to get paid? Because if you're in it to get paid, that's a reason to leave boxing. That's a reason to retire. You know what I'm saying? Get out of the sport, period. Come on, man. You said you were going to do something. You got to do it. I agree. Be a man of your word. You know what I'm saying? Be a man of your word. When Ryan was going through it, we all talked shit. Now that Broner is going through it, it's let's make excuses. I agree, man. I agree. I don't care if it's Ryan Garcia. I don't care if it's Adrian Broner. I don't even care if it's one of my favorite fighters, Deontay Wilder. I'm holding you accountable. You know what I'm saying? I don't care what your excuses are. No, I'm not cut that way. I believe in the personal accountability. Broner is a clown. He'll be running his mouth in a month as usual. That's up for debate. You know what I'm saying? I can't say the man is a clown. Like I said, he's won four champions and championships in four different divisions. Maybe he's displaying clownish behavior. But he is not a clown. You know what I'm saying? The man is one of the best to do it. And he deserves our respect in that aspect. You know what I'm saying? But I want to say thank you, thank you, thank you. I appreciate you guys for checking out another episode of the Gloves Off Podcast. Shout out to my chat room. Shout out to my brother, Mr. Taryn Rodriguez, the hardest working man here at IE Sports Radio. Shout out to my brother, Larry B. Thank you, thank you, thank you. If you're listening to the replay, you know, you're part of that replay gang gang. Do your boy a solid and share my shit. You know what I'm saying? Make sure to follow me on Twitter at Gloves Off Boxing, where we talk about all things that are combat sports. And please, please, please support the podcast. Support IE Sports Radio by signing up to our Patreon at patreon.com/IE Sports Radio. This is your boy, Marcus Lowe's Great. I'm out. I'm on to the next one.
Thank you for listening to the Gloves Off podcast, brought to you by IE Sports Radio.